CNN. A large Chinese rocket that is out of control is set to re-enter Earth's atmosphere this weekend, bringing a final wave of concern before its debris makes impact somewhere on Earth. The Long March 5B rocket, which is around 100 feet tall and weighs 22 tons, is expected to enter Earth's atmosphere around May 8, according to a statement from Defense Department spokesperson Mike Howard, who said the U.S. Space Command is tracking the rocket's trajectory. The rocket's exact entry point into the Earth's atmosphere can't be pinpointed until within hours of re-entry, Howard said, but the 18th Space Control Squadron is providing daily updates on the rocket's location through the Space Track website. The good news is that debris plunging toward Earth while unnerving generally poses very little threat to personal safety. The risk that there will be some damage or that it would hit someone is pretty small, not negligible. It could happen, but the risk that it will hit you is incredibly tiny. And so I would not lose one second of sleep over this on a personal threat basis, Jonathan McDowell, an astrophysicist at the Astrophysics Center at Harvard University, told CNN this week. The European Space Agency has predicted a risk zone that encompasses any portion of Earth's surface between about 41.5 N and 41.5 S latitude, which includes virtually all of the Americas south of New York, all of Africa and Australia, parts of Asia south of Japan and Europe's Spain, Portugal, Italy, and Greece. Chinese rocket debris is expected to crash into Earth soon. It and #39s not the first time. Chinese rocket debris is expected to crash into Earth soon. It's not the first time. That enormous range is, in part, a result of the rocket's blistering speed. Even slight changes in circumstance can drastically change its trajectory. We expect it to re-enter sometime between the 8th and 10th of May. And in that two-day period, it goes around the world 30 times, McDowell said. The thing is traveling at like 18,000 miles an hour. And so if you're an hour out at guessing when it comes down, you're 18,000 miles out in saying where. Still, the ocean remains the safest bet for where the debris will land, he said, just because it takes up most of the Earth's surface. If you want to bet on where on Earth something's going to land, you bet on the Pacific, because Pacific is most of the Earth. It's that simple, McDowell explained. The rocket launched a piece of the new Chinese space station into orbit on April 29, but then was left to hurtle through space uncontrolled until Earth's gravity began pulling it back to the ground. That approach is a break with what McDowell calls best practice compared with what other space agencies do. Norms have been established, he said. There's no international law or rule, nothing specific, but the practice of countries around the world has been, yeah, for the bigger rockets, let's not leave our trash in orbit in this way. Despite recent efforts to better regulate and mitigate space debris, Earth's orbit is littered with hundreds of thousands of pieces of uncontrolled junk, most of which are smaller than 10 centimeters, about 4 inches. Objects are constantly falling out of orbit, though most of them burn up in the Earth's atmosphere before they have a chance to make an impact on the surface. CNN's Jackie Wattles contributed to this report. China has played down fears that its Long March 5B rocket could hit a populated area or a plane in flight, but there is no shortage of problem debris in orbit. 259. Sometime this weekend, the upper stage of a Chinese Long March 5B rocket will plunge back to Earth and most of it will burn up on re-entry, but perhaps not all. Military experts in the US expect the booster stage to come down on Saturday or Sunday, but have warned it is difficult to predict where it will land and when and how much material might hit the ground, or if it could knock a plane out of the sky. The Chinese government, perhaps predictably, is playing it calmly. The probability of causing harm to aviation activities or on people and activities on the ground is extremely low, the foreign ministry spokesman, Wang Wenbin, said on Friday. Heavenly Harmony, China launches first module of new space station, video. 113. Heavenly Harmony, China launches first module of new space station, video. But the fiery fate of the booster, wherever it comes down, speaks to the larger issue of space debris and space sustainability, especially as space becomes a target not just for national space programs but also increasingly the private sector. Under international treaty, private space actors, who are expected to put 45,000 satellites in low Earth orbit over the next several years, are under the legal responsibility of their host nations. Advertisement. Add to that, an estimated 9,300 tons of space junk that's already orbiting the planet, and the issue of space collisions and debris pollution is an issue of concern. Last month, mission controllers at SpaceX headquarters in California warned orbiting astronauts to put on their space suits and get back in their seats because a piece of space debris could strike the capsule. Previously, a piece of paint the size of a fingernail struck the windscreen of a space shuttle, piercing two of three layers of glass. Space debris has been known for a while, but now you have more competition in space. You don't just have two spacefaring nations, the Chinese are very significant, as is the European Space Agency, among others. When you have more actors and more stuff, it gets more complicated, said Joanne Gabrino, is a professor at the National Center for Remote Sensing, Air, and Space Law at the Mississippi Law Center. Experts have repeatedly voiced their worry about the risk of collision since 2009, when two satellites, Iridium 33 and the derelict Russian military Cosmos 2251, accidentally collided at 26,000 miles per hour over Siberia, shattering both in thousands of pieces. The European Space Agency hosted a major conference on the subject last month. There's a lot of stuff being put into low Earth orbit, and some of it could possibly hit one another, said Gabrinowitz. According to Jonathan McDowell, an astrophysicist at the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics, China had every reason to know Long March 5B was unpredictable and would become uncontrollable. It's my judgment that the Chinese are negligent. China says it will probably fall in the ocean. But probably is doing a lot of work here. The last one would probably fall in the ocean, except it didn't. It fell on the Ivory Coast, he said. An Ivorian gendarme takes notes next to debris that fell from space in the village of Nguessankro near Bouake in Central Region in Ivory Coast on May 12, 2020. An Ivorian gendarme takes notes next to debris that fell from space in the village of Nguessankro near Bouake in Central Region in Ivory Coast on May 12, 2020. Photograph, AFP via Getty Images. The fate of Long March 5B could refocus governments and international bodies on the issue of space sustainability, and that could provide more opportunity to firms like UK-based Astroscale that are preparing to tackle the debris problem with commercial junk collecting services. According to the European Space Agency, about 6,900 of 11,370 satellites placed into Earth orbit are still circulating, with about 4,000 functioning.